name is Tivo, and I'm a junior at JHS.
My name is Justin, and I'm a senior.
My name is Isaac, and I'm also a junior. And we are all hosts on JHS's and Mass Media's The Nest. And The Nest is basically a talk show brought to you by Mass Media, and it's meant to educate, inform, and entertain the students and staff of Jefferson High School. I think first off, we have some questions for the hosts.
Yep, that's right. And the first question is, how did we become host and why? Isaac, do you want to start us off?
Yeah, sure. Basically, what I first did was join the class Mass Media, and then we started talking about making The Nest, and one of the positions that needed to be filled was a host, and I was interested in that. So I made a video at my house, an audition thing, and I basically interviewed my friend George Sandy about his film life and what he does, and then I filmed a little intro about myself, introducing myself as a host, and then I sent that video footage in to the producers of Mass Media and Mr. Garung, and they evaluated it, and they picked me, I guess. So, yeah, I'm here.
Sweet. So, who did you interview, Tivo?
I interviewed my mother on how to be an adult.
Cool.
Which included how to get an apartment, how to get contract for said apartment, how to, you know, just general things like
basic adulting.
Yeah, how to, you know, not let your kid die.
That's very important, you know.
Very.
My mom has done a very good job at that. Mm-hmm. Speaking of which, though, I interviewed my mom as well, but it was more about her life story and just her growing up in Mexico and then moving into the States and then meeting my dad and having me and my sister and then up until now.
That's really interesting.
Yeah. So the next question is, what are some interesting / unique hobbies you're into? Tivo, you want to start this one?
I don't really have much time for hobbies, but
what?
I like to draw a lot. And
what type of art do you do?
I like drawing cartoons and somewhat realistic scenes, I guess. And I like blending colors together just to make unique backgrounds.
What do you mean by somewhat realistic?
Like
dragons?
Like dragons, like dinosaurs, like, you know, stuff like that.
I guess they're considered realistic at a time. What about you, Isaac?
A little bit of goblins.
What was the question?
What are some interesting, unique hobbies / interests you have?
I really like watching movies.
And what kind of movies?
All kinds of movies. We have like these big shelves in my basement that open up, and you've got like all your DVDs and all your like VHS for like the really old stuff. You know, barely works anymore. But yeah, I like to watch movies. I like to try to make movies. I like to act and stuff. Basically, everything in that area. It's really fun.
Sounds fun. I actually am into sort of filming as well. Like I'm probably not as much into as you, but I have done some like YouTube videos and other. Sort of like interviews and other videos. And I'm also into drawing as well. And a third thing I guess I'm into, that's my unique talent, is I'm into dancing. I don't know if you guys know that, but
I've seen you dance.
Really?
You're pretty good.
Oh, wow, thanks. All right, on to our third question. If you had a third arm, would you want a third leg to match?
That's the question?
Yeah, that's the question.
Okay, I'm not going first, I don't know.
You want to go first or do you want me?
You should go first.
All right.
I have no idea.
So, I don't think I would want a third leg to match with my third arm because I feel my third arm would be useful, whereas my third leg would get in the way. Because, like, where would it go? Because I feel like my third arm, wherever it's going to be useful. But a third leg is, like, who likes a three-legged stool? No, it's like, you need four or just two.
Oh, yeah, that makes sense because, like,
a three-legged stool would stand better than a two-legged stool.
Yeah, but what about a motorcycle? What's cooler? Like a motorcycle or a little three thing. Like, you know, the three things, like the little training wheels. Like a stool with three legs is like a training wheel. Like, you don't need it. You just go either two or four.
I would just be constantly tripping on myself. And it wouldn't be fun. So, yeah, three arms and...
Two legs.
Yeah.
What about you, Isaac?
Do I even need to have the third arm?
Yes, it's not an option.
You have the third arm. You were born with the third arm.
Well, actually, death is the other option.
Okay. Well, opposed to death. Hey!
I like it.
No, it's mine. It's okay. Opposed to death, I suppose I would not want the third leg, just because I've already got a third arm. That's so weird.
Wow. I did not expect all of us to agree.
Social outcast, you know, not really feeling it.
You're kind of already a social outcast with a third arm.
Oh, I thought you just meant me already.
No, no, I wouldn't. No, I meant like with your third arm.
Yeah, but sure, right. I don't know. I mean,
I like that we all agreed, that we all came to the same thought process, and we were all very logical with it. All right, and the last question is, what is your spirit vegetable?
My spirit vegetable is a turnip, because turnips are strong in both flavor and texture.
That was a very well-thought-out answer. Isaac, what's your answer?
I don't know if I necessarily understand the question. What's a spirit vegetable?
Just answer the question.
I don't know what
I think
it means.
It's pretty self-explanatory.
It is very self-explanatory.
I bet, like, everybody in the audience knows what I'm
everybody
talking
knows.
About.
Everybody knows.
Pretty sure. Everybody knows. Like, anybody else, I'd just be like, oh, what's your spirit vegetable? They give any random vegetable.
Jake, do you know what it's... He's shrugging. He doesn't know.
Well, Jake's special. You know, Jake hasn't been in the world
in
of spirit vegetables. You haven't experienced the spirit vegetables. You haven't been enlightened by the vegetables.
I haven't either. Please enlighten me.
All right, well, the great corn god, he...
The great cornucopia.
The great cornucopia, yes.
You're just making this up.
No, this is completely real.
Looks.
He is all vegetables, okay? Yeah. And then every other vegetable is descended of that corn.
Yes.
And every person in the world is...
Okay, this sounds like this is going to be a long explanation. I'm just going to answer.
All right, thank you. Fine.
Corn. Because it's the god, I guess.
It can't be corn. It can't be god.
Yeah. All right, but I guess we'll keep it.
I pick corn.
Isaac doesn't...
All hail spirit vegetable. Isaac.
My spirit vegetable would be a broccoli. And every
Why?
Time... Because they have little tree heads. And every time people would look away from me, I'd, like, dance my little tree heads around.
No.
And then when they would look back, I'd just stop.
So I have a question for you now. What do you think the most annoying trend will be this year?
Yes.
You know, there's actually one trend right now that just, I think, hit its peak a little bit ago, and it's called Salt Bae. I don't know if you guys know what that is.
Nope. Salt Bae?
And it's basically this guy who cuts up meat really, like, fancy, kind of. Like, you know, he, like, goes really intricate and like, precision. And then at the end, when he's done cutting the meat or preparing whatever he's done, takes some salt in his hand, bends his elbow, and just slowly lets it just trickle down. And then at the end, he just goes... That's that.
Yeah.
It's used a lot.
What? I would not watch that.
Yeah, it's getting kind of like old and repetitive. So that's what I think the most annoying trend is going to be.
No, I think the most annoying trend will be chef hats and gold chains and sport shades. That combination is just, I don't know.
What would that even look like?
Well, I'm glad you asked.
Uh-oh.
You did not. Did you really?
Drop the shades.
You brought these items.
Yes, I did.
Oh, nice.
You
catch.
Have thought very well into these questions.
Yes, it did.
So, shades.
Shades.
Upside down shades.
Yes, they have to be upside down.
They have to?
Have to, or else it doesn't
and
look cool.
I have one question. Can you see in that?
I can see. I have 21/21 vision right now.
That's not
actually
a thing.
Yeah, I don't think
it so. Is. It is a thing with these shades.
Oh, okay.
Just because you're kind of blind doesn't mean
how dare you.
You can hate on these shades.
Tivo, I don't think this is trendy at all.
I think this is the trendiest.
I think you're kind of...
You know what? You're right. I'm missing something, actually.
Oh,
okay.
Look what you've done.
What you,
pardon me, Isaac.
You've started
What is he grabbing?
This.
What is that? What is that? Why are you... Don't know.
Most fashionable
What
coat.
Is in that pocket?
No.
I don't even know. That's
we're
a Mexico.
Not, we're not letting you back on camera.
I think you are.
I don't
just, I am
stuff you got on.
Square
what are
shoulders.
Tivo, that doesn't... None of that goes together. None
yes,
of that...
it does. You're wrong.
Okay,
you know
why
what?
Do you need a chef
okay.
hat with glasses?
Where
Chefs
am I
are indoor.
Where am I going to buy these
Where
items?
Are you going to buy these items?
Where am I going to get these items to follow this trend?
Quick Trip.
Okay.
Military surplus store. My mom's closet.
Tivo, I don't think I can...
I'm not going to go into your mom's closet to get...
Close.
It's a very limited trend. You can't catch on with this.
I don't think so.
I think you guys are right. You know what? You're right.
Yeah. I think we should... Like, let's talk
right.
about some stuff that's actually in style.
So like parachute pants?
No. No. I don't know. Let's see. What else is going on currently? Have you seen any TV shows recently?
Stranger Things.
Oh.
Amazing.
There we go.
I've,
that's something we can talk about.
I love that show.
Wait a... Catch up on TV, Tivo. You just need to catch up in the outfit. All right.
Yeah.
So, Stranger Things.
You need to modernize
Great
yourself,
show.
Sir.
I haven't seen it. What is it about?
How dare you? It is about strange things that happen in a small Indiana town.
In the 80s, so it's 80s. Cool.
In the 80s?
Retro.
Tivo, I think you should be in the show. I think you do very well.
Yeah. All right. This shirt was not mentioned before, but kind of in the...
I'm not too familiar with Stranger Things, but I know about Walking Dead a little. Not a lot, but a little bit.
Is that the show on AMC?
How little?
With the chemist?
Yeah,
the
ball, no. Ball guy?
That's
no.
Breaking Bad.
That's something completely different. No, Walking Dead is about the zombie apocalypse happening and this group of people that are basically the main characters and just them surviving in this post-apocalyptic world and just meeting other people in the time and, you know, just trying to survive.
Yeah, it's still going on, too. Unlike the 80s.
Yeah.
And their trends.
You know what? Mixtapes were pretty cool. And Source.
I have to agree with you.
I like record players. And
record players.
Yeah. Fashions, however, just kind of gross.
Really?
Yeah.
I am appalled, actually.
I don't know, Tivo. I think you're kind of like, you're just kind of stressing me out, man. You're like coming in here with all these colorful and just odd things. I think, I don't know. Isaac, I think we should give you some time to talk. I don't know. Do you have anything to talk about? Any events or any news discussions?
Ah, yes. The film festival.
Oh, that's cool.
It is cool, Justin. It's very, very, very cool.
Yeah, I think I
what
like her.
What is the film festival? That's a great question.
I don't think I asked.
Well, students.
Wait. What's the film festival? Can you enlighten me?
Wait, but...
he keeps on interrupting us.
Oh, true. True! Thank you, Tivo. Hey, yeah, so what is the film festival, Isaac?
What is the film festival, students? That's a great question. Well, the film festival is basically a film sort of competition that JHS is hosting this year. Basically, what you do to get involved in that is groups of JHS students get together, and they pick a writer, a director, and some actors, and they basically make their own original short film. Short films are usually from about 5 minutes to 20 minutes, and they make it, and it's all original. It has to be school appropriate, obviously. And then they send it in, and there's judging, and then the judges like assign it awards, and then to present those awards, we have a showing in the auditorium at 7 p.m. on March 31st, and we show the videos, and we get awards.
What kind of
awards? What kind of awards? Exactly. Good question. Well, I happen to carry these around with me at all times.
What are those?
What are these? That's a good question. These.
Can you see one?
Nope, that's mine. You can't touch that. These are called shorties.
I mean, yeah.
Why are they called shorties? That's a good question.
Because they're short, right?
Pretty sure.
No, it's because.
Pretty short.
They are for short films. That's why they're called shorties.
What do they say?
Well, give me that.
Are short films also short, like these?
Yes.
Okay.
Good. Yes.
I think that's
good connection. This one was for Best Director, that was me, 2015. This one is for Best Director, that's also me, 2016, so 2 years in a row. No.
Are any of these for us?
What a chance.
No, these are all mine. Okay. Then this is Best Thriller, 2016, that was for the film I made with some of my buds. And this is for Best Musical Score, 2016, which is also for the film I made with some of my buds.
Who did you make the film with?
George Sandy.
Oh, the one you interviewed?
Yes.
Oh, sweet.
And Mitchell Glider and Jane Gallardo. And we made like a Sherlock Holmes kind of short film thriller. Sort. Why? No.
Hey, wait, these aren't all yours. What does this one say?
This is mine.
No. This one says at all costs.
That's the name of the film. These are all
okay.
Mine.
This one says
no,
IT.
Stop touching them.
Okay. I'm just making sure. I don't want you stealing these.
How do I get involved in the film festival?
Oh, yeah, that's a good question. How do we get involved?
It's too late.
Is it really?
No, it's not. It's never too late. Remember that, kids.
Basically,
you can talk to me, myself, or Nora Harsford, or Mr. Clarkson, and we will all give you information on that. There is a video out on the YouTubes and the Facebook, and that has a little promo video that I'm also starring in that kind of explains what the Film Fest is in more detail and how to get involved. Some of the rules.
All right,
so
sweet.
We can talk after this.
Speaking of which, I think we should go into a new topic, and we've actually, the mass media team has prepared a little segment that involves two of our students.
Because I'm tired of talking.
Yeah, I'm getting tired too. Basically, it's a talk show where they bring in guests, and they get really mad. And sometimes
it's
not pretty.
A little teed off,
yeah,
you might say.
So, Jake?
Hey, Trevor.
You got a show?
Yeah, I don't know how we did it. Honestly, this is ridiculous.
It is. We're, like, famous or something.
Well, you know, at least I did something right my senior year.
Yeah, we got some tea, too.
Yeah, I got that, too.
Great tea. Tastes funky.
Doesn't seem like tea. No, it's kind of good. All right, okay.
It's got a weird tangy taste.
It's cold.
It is cold.
Don't we have someone, like, here or something?
To get us tea?
No. Yeah. Like, I think this chair's here for somebody, right? Like,
oh, yeah.
Who's it for?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my producer. I think it's Andie.
That might be her.
Yeah. Andie?
She's,
Andie.
Oh,
Andie!
Hello.
Hey. Oh, here's our guest, Andrea.
Yeah.
She's a little bit late, but we'll
have to.
Be careful.
Oh, sorry.
Okay, hey, watch out for that. It's dangerous. So, what are you studying in school?
In what class?
Okay, I guess you just can be like that.
Oh, inconsiderate.
I'm just asking, like, generally, like, what do you do at school? Like, what's the thing that you enjoy doing?
Mass media is pretty
cool. Yeah.
And what is mass media?
A bunch of different things.
Mm-hmm. What is that supposed to be?
Oh, Trevor.
Yeah?
I forgot. This is teed off, by the way. Okay, so anyone forgot, this is this show where we...
get very angry.
We just bring people in, and they sit down, and they just, like, whatever, do whatever they want, and we just say stuff, and ooh, it's really funny.
Where's my tea?
You think you get tea? Why? Why would we give you tea? Because
I'm your guest.
Keep that up. Won't be for long. So, Andie, how do you like cats?
Cats are great.
No, they're not.
Do you like cats?
No.
Why?
Because. Jake, do you like cats?
I'm fond of bears. Bears are really cool.
Like,
you know,
they're
really. I hear they're really warm on the inside.
What about the football team?
Yeah.
You like that?
What?
You like the football team?
Yeah. No.
No.
What? Yeah.
I'm
so you
sure.
Like cats?
I do.
Oh, that's cool. So what's your cat's name?
Oh, Wilson.
Wilson. So it's a guy, right?
No, it's a girl.
What? What makes you think that's okay?
I don't know. I kind of like the name Wilson. And the person I got my cat from only had girls left.
You're killing me, Smalls. So let's talk about dogs, because they're so much better than cats. What do you think about dogs, Andrea?
I have a couple dogs.
Oh,
cool.
What type of dogs?
Labs.
Ooh, that's cool. I have a golden retriever. Yep. We should have a cat and dog like play party where
no.
A dog just eats out each cat.
Okay, stop. I'm done. I'm talking to you. You can stop talking now.
Excuse me.
This is the Jake and Trevor show, okay?
It's the Trevor and Jake show.
Listen, when we first came up with this, it was my idea. It was Jake talks, okay? And then you butted in, and you thought that you deserve a spot in my show. And I was like, okay, I have to give something to you. I mean,
you just
do something right.
Punch a wall.
Punch a wall. All right. So as I was saying, so what are you studying in high school?
Couple classes.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Wait.
You want my schedule?
Are you done talking over me now? Can I speak, please? This
yeah.
is my show, so I think I deserve
it's
it
my
all.
Show.
Oh my God. Don't look over there, by the way. Just, can you scoot over a little?
Oh, sure.
Yeah. Sleep over there a little bit.
Oh, that's a bias.
It's a better over here. So, what do you think of the show? You think the show's good? Do you think it's bad? What do you think?
I like it.
You like it?
You like it? Do you really?
Your guests should probably have tea, though. That'd be a little bit nicer.
What do you think about this?
Oh, what is that?
It's a tongue. Here.
Oh,
put
no, I'm okay.
You put it right
oh,
there.
Thank you.
That's, you're the guest for our first show. You deserve something, right?
You don't want this tea, by the way. It's really bad.
I'm...
It doesn't look like tea.
What are you talking about? It's tea!
smell like tea.
It's tea.
It's all black. Well, this is the first thing. Can you leave?
Oh,
just
yeah.
Get out.
Sorry, thanks.
Careful for the bear.
Oh, sorry.
Take the tongue, please.
The tongue.
Oh.
Put the tongue back.
I thought it was mine.
No.
I don't know what gave you that assumption. Put it back in the mouth.
Put it back.
Stop. Just go. Just
okay.
Go. I'll do it.
You just made me so angry.
Sorry.
Okay. Well, everybody, that was...
That was our first viewing.
It was, I think it... What? Teed off?
What do we call this?
I think we call it teed off. Jake and Trevor. Teed off Jake and Trevor.
Trevor and Jake.
Jake and Trevor teed off show.
If your lawyer would not sue me, I would throw this at you.
Cut!
Man, those are some angry men.
Yeah, it was pretty interesting.
Yeah, I thought it was pretty mediocre.
It was like 12 angry men minus 10 men. They just got really mad. I don't know if it's safe to keep them on air.
Oh, I thought it was pretty fun.
I think we should.
I was
fire
scared
them.
For Andy's life.
I don't know. I'll back them up. I think they're doing a great job.
All right. I think we should get like restraining orders and.
I just want to forget that happened
out there.
That was weird.
Well, it's time to wrap up. But before we do, I want to address this painting here.
Ah. Yes.
What's that?
I believe it's a betta fish.
Is that an eagle?
No.
No.
It's got wings like one.
That's an eagle.
No. That is actually the betta fish.
How did you, Tivo, how'd you become a host on The Nest when you can't even tell?
You don't know what an eagle is.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Okay, well, basically, this is a good chance because the little activity we have planned is we're each going to take turns on saying what we think this is trying to state, what it means, you know? Get to its core. Tivo, you can start, because you're obviously confused.
Okay, is there a limitation to what I can say?
Just keep it school appropriate, please.
Okay.
There are children listening.
Am I trapped in this bowl of water? Let me be free. I think this is about...
freedom?
About freedom and about those who don't get to experience it.
So it's a jailed fish.
Yeah, the fish is supposed to represent, it's actually eagle though, but fish is supposed to represent something.
That's a beta fish.
It's supposed to represent people.
Okay, you're done.
Okay.
Justin, it's your turn.
I think it's pretty.
It's
gorgeous.
It's very good. Apt of you, Justin. Very apt.
Yeah.
Okay, well... What does it say to me? I don't know. I don't really think
there's
it
no words.
Say anything.
Of course it doesn't say anything.
I think this betta fish here, I think it's silent.
Oh,
it's silence itself is what speaks most of all. It says, look at me. But it doesn't say, look at me. It can't talk.
Eagles can talk.
It just, you see in its eye, and its tail, and its
dead
appendages,
eye.
That it says, I am what I am. A betta fish. Nothing more. Maybe a little bit less.
That was beautiful, Isaac.
Thank you. And with that,
okay.
Justin will wrap up this episode.
All right, well, that's it for today, guys. You know, tune in next week for the next episode of The Nest. And, bam, we're out.